biological knowledge. So in the previous lecture or in the previous discussion, we have discussed about the key minerals or the key base metals of Andhra Pradesh state, and that video was very useful for the state PSC examination as well as for the geology related examination. And in the same series, today we will discuss a very important topic, that is the geology and mineral resources of Odisha state. Okay, so what is the purpose behind the discussion of this topic? So if you analyze the distribution of deposits in Indian subcontinent, you will find that Odisha is very famous state, okay, for the deposits, whether they are the mineral deposits or the ore deposits or the fuel deposits. So all these deposits are very renowned in this state. So today we will discuss the geology as well as the mineral resources of this state, and we will take only the basic overview, because it's a long topic, and we will take only the basic overview, and in the succession of that video, that will follow by the detailed description. Okay, so let's start our discussion. So this is a very simplified geological map of Odisha, though it's not very clear, but you can see the famous localities like alluvium or the laterite or the boulder beds, okay, or the charnokite beds. So it's not very clear, but you can see in this map. And the remain, this one is a clear one, okay, that has been compiled by N.K. Mahalik sir. Okay, so this is a clear cut map, more clearer than the previous one. Okay, so in this map you can say that the green part, that is the most important Simlipal complex or the Simlipal group, okay, of Proterozoic age. And in the same, in the Proterozoic age, in the left hand side or in the north southwest quadrant, you can see a bed or marked by pink A, that is known as Kudappa and the Vindhyan system. Okay, D is the Kalhan, and if we talk about C, so C is the Gangpur series. Okay, and same is the, if we talk about in quaternary system, that is that by pink, that is the Badripada, or with the yellow is the alluvium or the laterite. Okay, and same is if you talk about banded iron formation, so that has been shown by sky color, light sky blue color, and that is formed, that is shown as Bangapal at the point D. And if we talk about C, B, A, so they are banded iron formations located at banded iron formation 3, banded iron formation 2, and banded iron formation 1 subsequently. So this is very basic map, okay, and our motto is not to discuss this map. Our motto is to study the mineralogicals or the geology and mineralogy of Odisha. Okay, so this map is very important, but our discussion, our topic is something else. Okay, we will discuss this map when we will talk about the Singhbhum Craton. Okay, and we all know that more than 80% of Singhbhum Craton lies in the state of Odisha. Okay, so we will talk about there. Today's focus is on the minerals and the geology of Odisha. Okay, so let's start our discussion, which is the topic. So if we talk about the situation or the location of Odisha, so it's situated on the eastern seaboard of India. It's one of the gifted parts of world where a gamut of mineral resources exist in bounty. Okay, so there are a lot of mineral resources. We will discuss it one by one in a nutshell. Okay, our discussion will be a nutshell, because we cannot discuss all the descriptive things in a particular one video. This is only the basic video of that. If we talk about the enrichment, so a state is endowed with a large reservoir of bauxite, china clay, chromite, coal or dolomite, as well as fire clay, graphite, gemstones, iron ore, limestones, manganese ores, mineral sand, nickel ore, or pyrophyllite and quartz. So you can see that so many minerals are existing there. Their quality or quantity may vary, but the occurrence is so high. And if we talk about the recent discovery of diamond, there has been a recent discovery of diamond in the Dharmband area of Nuapada district. In the Dharmband area of Nuapada district, a recent discovery of diamond has been found by the State Directorate of Geology that has added a colored feather in the cap of the state. Okay, so that is the recent discovery of diamond. Area is important. Dharmband area of Nuapada district. And if we talk about the major minerals or the ores which are found, so minerals of the state include copper ore, lead ore, titanium bearing vanadiferous magnetite, talc soap stone, and high magnesia igneous rock. Okay, situated on the eastern fringe of the peninsular India, Odisha has about 72.5% of the area occupied by Precambrian metamorphic rocks. Okay, so source rock or the host rock is very important. I have been repeatedly discussing about the source rock or the host rock because it's very important to know that in which source rock the A, B, C or XYZ minerals is found, is being explored or is being mined. So 72.5% of area occupied by Precambrian metamorphic rocks, and age is also important. Archean and Proterozoic age means somewhat 2.2 to 2.5 billion years, which host the majority of the minerals. Okay, so majority of the minerals, they are found in the Precambrian metamorphic rocks, basically of Archean and the Proterozoic age. The Gondwana hosting the coal resource occur over about 8% of the landmass. So the occurrence of Gondwana coal that is hosted by the 8% of the landmass of the state. Okay, so that is also important, the coal reserve. The tertiary and quaternary formations occupying rest of the area provide avenues for aluminous, nickeliferous, laterite and heavy minerals in the beach sand of Odisha, in the beach sand of sea region or the oceanic region. The Archean rocks in the northern Odisha include the supracrustal belts of metasedimentary rocks which include iron ore supergroup. Okay, that is very important to notice that Archean rocks in the northern fringe or the northern fringe of Odisha, that includes the supracrustal belt of metasedimentary rocks, and that includes the famous iron ore supergroup having deposits of iron, manganese, gold as well as base metals. So in the previous lectures we have discussed about the distribution of iron, manganese, these two and some other base metals. So when we were discussing about iron and manganese, we have also discussed that they hold a huge amount of iron and manganese, especially in the iron ore supergroup. Okay, if you have watched that video, you would have understood, okay, that thing. These are also represented by the gneisses, granite, migmatite of Singhbhum, Bonai and Mayurbhanj plutons. So host rock is gneisses, granites and the migmatites ऑफ सिंघभूम एंड बुनाई एंड मयूरभंज प्लूटॉन्स एंड मैफिक अल्ट्रा मैफिक इंट्रूसिव्स, ओके, ऑक्यूपाइड बाई मैफिक एंड अल्ट्रा मैफिक इंट्रूसिव्स. एंड वी टॉक अबाउट दीज इंट्रूसिव्स, सो दीज इंट्रूसिव्स आर एसोसिएटेड विद द मिनरल्स, विद द ओर मिनरल्स लाइक क्रोमाइट, टाइटेनिफेरस, वैनेडिफेरस मैग्नेटाइट एंड द PGM means the platinum group of minerals. They are also very important. Chromite, titaniferous, vanadiferous magnetite, as well as the platinum group of minerals, better known as PGM. And if we talk about the Bastar cratonic complex of Archinus in the western Odisha, that includes the gneisses, granites, migmatites, okay, and strontium, tantalum, niobium bearing pegmatites. So the pegmatites that bears niobium, tantalum and strontium, okay, that is also very important to notice. And if we talk about the proterozoic rocks, especially in the western fringe of Odisha, that exhibit plate formal sedimentary formations which are associated with the limestone deposits, okay. And if we talk about the northwestern Odisha, they contain metasediments of low to medium metamorphic grade, okay. In the northwestern fringe, they contain metasediments of low to medium metamorphic grade which are classified as the Gangpur group. As we have discussed in the map, the second map initially, that the Gangpur series or the Gangpur group in the northwestern fringe, that includes the metasediments of low to medium metamorphic grade, okay, and they host the manganese, limestone as well as the lead zinc deposit of the state, okay. So the Gangpur group that host manganese, limestone as well as the lead zinc deposit of the state. And if we talk about the central or the southern Odisha, so the Proterozoic and are represented by the Eastern Ghat Granulite Belt. Okay, Eastern Ghat Granulite Belt, especially in the central and the southern Odisha. They comprise most importantly the Chondrolites, Chernokites, as well as Migmatite, Anorthosite and the Alkaline rocks, okay. And if we talk of these, Chondrolites, Chernokites and Migmatites are very important because they are the host rock for several minerals and ore minerals, accounting for the mineralization of bauxite, manganese, graphite as well as the green stones. So these Eastern Ghat Granulite Belt that consists of these mineralization of bauxite, manganese, graphite as well as the green stones. And if we talk about the Mesozoic rocks of especially the Gondwana supergroup, that host the major coal resources of the state. We all know the Gondwana coal representation, the classification or the occurrence of Gondwana coal in the Mesozoic era. That host the major coal resources of the state. And formation of the Cenozoic is they occupy the eastern coastal plains in the form of alluvial sediments, okay. That Cenozoic is which occupy the eastern coastal plain in the form of alluvial sediment or the S beds and low level laterite, providing avenues for occurrence of beach sand minerals and the building materials, okay. That thorium mineralization in the beach sand of Kerala, beach sand of the Odisha. The deltaic fans extending into the offshore region play host for the oil and the shale, okay. So that deltaic fans that extend into the offshore region, that is the host for the oil and shale. Odisha has a lion's share of the country's mineral reserve, okay. So this is in nutshell. In nutshell, if we have to say one in one sentence, the occurrence of the deposits or the minerals or the ore minerals. So Odisha has a lion's share of country's mineral reserves, especially the chromite, nickel, bauxite, iron ore, and coal reserve. Okay. Of the state respectively stand at a staggering 83%, 92%, 55%, 38%, and 26% of the India's total reserve. Okay, respectively, means chromite, 83% of chromite is in Odisha state, 92% of nickel deposits are in Odisha state, bauxite 55%, iron 38%, and coal is 26%. So that is the percent of these minerals of India's total reserves. Okay, so we can say the extensive deposition or the extensive distribution of the mineral reserve. Several minerals based industries have already been come into the state. Okay, we are familiar with some of them. The major ones are the Rourkela steel plant, the aluminium refinery and smelter of NALCO. Okay, National Aluminium Company. Okay, and the charged chrome plants at Baminipal or the Bhadrak. Okay, and all at these regions respectively. And coal based thermal plants, they have also been set up at the Talcher, Kalihan or the Banhar Pali regions. Okay, so this was in a nutshell the distribution or the occurrences, only the major locations and their locations as well as the host rock and their stratigraphic distribution, means from the older to younger side. So that is the distribution in a nutshell. We can say the occurrences of the deposits or the ore minerals. Okay, so in next video or in the coming video, we will discuss in detail the important ore minerals, their petrology, their distribution and their occurrences as well as their structural properties. Okay, thank you.